I want to touch on this new reporting from the New York Times. George Papadopoulos telling Australian diplomat that Russia had political dirt on Hillary Clinton back in May of 2016. This was a driving factor, according to the New York Times report, for the FBI to launch their investigation. So, Andre, how does this affect Trump's White House view that this dossier prompted the FBI investigation? Apparently that wasn't the case.
Well, you know, the president a long time ago said that Trump Tower was had surveillance on it, and everybody laughed at him. This has gone on now for almost a year. They've been looking in Trump and Russian meddling. Well, I don't know what part's wrong, Mayor. Tell me where I'm wrong.
What evidence do you have that there was Russian surveillance?
The FBI has said that there was no surveillance. The FBI said that. Our FBI.
Not true. We do now know that Trump Tower was surveilled. I mean, how do you think they got information on Manafort?
The president said that Donald Trump said that President Obama had his building wired. The FBI said that is not true. There's no evidence of it. Look it up, Andre. Cut it out.
We know they had surveillance of Trump Tower. Anyway,
okay, Andre, stick to the facts
they had surveillance on foreign leaders because that's what we do.
But back to the question,
Andre. If you talk to spies, you will get picked up on those tapes. Yes.
But back to the question of this latest reporting, if indeed it was this Papadopoulos revelation, which was flagged by Australian officials to U.S. officials that led them and created this investigation to begin, that does fly in the face of what the narrative has been by a lot of Republican lawmakers and even the president at times, that this is all a hoax of an investigation sparked by a bogus dossier.
Look, all of us, this thing's gone on for a year and a half now. I know a lot of people would like to see it get over, me included, but several of the people doing the investigating, because they need to get back and help the Democrats raise money. I mean, we've got a tainted group of people doing the investigating. We know they're sending emails that say they're impartial to Donald Trump. We know they've raised money for the Democratic Party. This is not a fair and reasonable investigation. The reason why you have special counsel is to have people recused from the entire cesspool to do the investigation, and that's not the case at all. In fact, we have people that have a certain leaning in politics, and now they're doing the investigating, and that's not right.
Mayor Nutter?
Anna, let's be very, very clear from the start. First of all, the reason you have a special counsel is because the president, in his convoluted mind, fired the FBI director because of Russia. Andre, let me finish. Let me finish. I didn't interrupt you. Jeff Sessions, because he didn't tell Congress the truth under oath and had to go back, I think at least two other times, then ended up having to recuse himself because he suddenly forgot until he remembered that maybe he had some involvement with people in Russia. Rod Rosenstein was appointed by Donald Trump and is a Republican. Mr. Rosenstein appointed Mr. Mueller, who's also a Republican, and he's in charge. All this other lower level nonsense about who's emailing whom or whatever, Democrats and Republicans respect Mr. Mueller. He should not be interfered with. This is not a hoax. It is not fake news. There are three different congressional committees investigating all of this nonsense, all of which are headed by Republicans because you control the House and the Senate. The only person who believes that there's nothing going on here is Donald Trump, and his entire administration is on the verge of collapse. That's what the facts are.
We got to leave it there, but I do want to point out that there was an interview that the president gave this week, and he himself said now he believes that Robert Mueller will be fair in this investigation. Andre Bauer and Michael Nutter, thank you both for coming on for the spirited debate. I appreciate it.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you as well. Coming up.